Since 2009, Chopped has been blessing Food Network viewers with the kind of fast-paced kitchen competition content we crave. But the show, as it turns out, isn't exactly the best guide for how to operate in the kitchen. Here are the lies that Chopped made you believe about cooking. We're absolutely not saying that you should always add dozens of complex ingredients to a kitchen mainstay, but the Chopped judge's insistence that a meal's four basket ingredients make up the core of every dish is not good cooking advice. Yes, some simple recipes are fantastic, but so are complex ones. And just because a recipe has a grocery store aisle's worth of ingredients doesn't mean you shouldn't give it a try. Have a little fun in the kitchen and try ingredient-dense and complicated recipes if you feel like being fancy. We believe in you.
You want to win $10,000? Bring it.
I got it. You'll see.
Just because the Chopped chefs are tasked with making four unique ingredients the absolute stars of a dish does not mean that you, as a home cook, should feel the need to do the same. In Chopped lore, it's common to believe that if you make it to the fateful dessert round, the one thing you need to push your final dish over the finish line is a fresh churned ice cream, sometimes combined with very bizarre basket ingredients. And as good as a weirdly savory ice cream may sound, it turns out real live kitchen chefs don't actually need to reach for that ice cream machine. There are literally hundreds of desserts that are not ice cream that are every bit as good, if not better. But if you can't be talked out of making ice cream at home, there are plenty of no-churn methods to try. Even for Chopped contestants, the ice cream machine may not be the best way to go, since every fan of the show knows there's only one machine. Ever wonder why they can't just buy a second one? As several judges on Chopped admit, the single machine adds drama to the show. Luckily, that drama doesn't need to translate to your kitchen because you don't need to make ice cream at home. On Chopped, contestants have, depending on the round, 20 or 30 minutes to make a dish. In real life, it's probably going to take you quite a bit longer if you're putting together a recipe. And that's a good thing. Fast cooking does not necessarily yield good food. A slower heat can make tougher cuts of meat more tender and can increase the flavor in just about any dish. Not only that, but slow cooking can be easier than faster methods of cooking. Many slow cooking recipes simply involve popping prepped ingredients in a slow cooker in the morning and plating the finished meal for dinner in the evening. Low and slow isn't going to work on Chopped, but it may be the best bet for the average home cook. Taking your time to cook at home may be able to improve your mental health too. Slowing down and taking the time to cook while paying close attention to the taste of ingredients can help people manage anxiety, whereas cooking with the frantic pace of a Chopped contestant probably isn't the best way to wind down after a long day. On Chopped, using a pre-made aioli can be deadly for contestants in the appetizer and entree rounds, but in real life, store-bought aioli and mayonnaise can be your best friend. We mean no disrespect to homemade aioli, but if you're spending valuable time whisking your own oil and eggs for health or taste reasons when making something as simple as a sandwich or an aioli-based salad dressing, consider skipping it. Tuna salad with store-bought aioli can be just as good, if not better, than tuna salad with a gourmet aioli. If you do want to exercise your Chopped chef skills and make that aioli yourself, be our guest. Consider starting with basic mayonnaise from Samin Nosrat, host of Salt, Fat, Acid, Heat. It's perfect for sandwiches, French fries, and salads, plus you can easily alter it for more complex flavor. You may want to stretch beforehand, as this recipe is a workout on the forearms. The contestants on Celebrity Chopped episodes typically tend to be, let's face it, horrible. Plenty of superstars have competed in the Reality Kitchen Showdown, like basketball player Charles Oakley, musician Coolio, Comedy Central star Sinbad, and High School Musical drama geek Lucas Grabeel. And some have been more successful than others. On the Celebrity Chopped episodes, there tends to be an attitude that celebrities, be it due to fame or wealth or maybe laziness, cannot cook. But this isn't true for lots of celebrities out there. Plenty of celebrities are great cooks, and many have even written cookbooks. Of these, supermodel and Twitter personality extraordinaire Chrissy Teigen may be the most notable with her successful cookbook, Cravings. But did you know rapper 2 Chainz can also throw down in the kitchen? Or that musician Questlove has written his own cookbook? Former Sister Sister star Tia Mowry even has her own cooking show. Celebrities, they're just like us, except some are much, much better cooks.
And that means, Brandi Chastain, that you are the Chopped champion, and that we will see you back here again for the Tournament of Stars finale.
It's every Chopped chef's worst nightmare. They rush to finish cooking and plate their culinary creation as Ted Allen counts down from 10. The chef wipes stray sauce from the rim of the plate, inhales the aroma, and steps back with their hands up, only to realize they've forgotten an entire ingredient. Fortunately for home chefs, this cooking nightmare is completely limited to the universe of Chopped, and you're unlikely to face it in the comfort of your own kitchen. Even if you do start baking and realize you've forgotten that one key ingredient, there's a world of other options as substitutions. For instance, did you know you can use applesauce instead of eggs in your chocolate chip cookies? Vegans have been doing it for years. Just make sure you're not the unfortunate chef who mistakes salt for sugar. There's really no coming back from that one, even in your own kitchen. While this is technically doable even for home chefs, maybe consider not melting leftover candy down into an edible sauce. It seems like Ted Allen's favorite Chopped trick to play is to give contestants a sweet, sticky food in an early round that they have to scramble to find a place for. Savory chocolate sauces are actually quite common and easy, and Chopped chefs are well aware of that. But as far as those fruity, sweet confections go, the recipes aren't as simple. It turns out, if you're not actually competing on Chopped, there really isn't any reason to melt down your candy into some sort of salad dressing or marinating liquid. Instead, consider this tried and true recipe for candy that we swear by. Open the candy bag and then eat the candy. Much better, right? One of the first things most people learn as home cooks is that you have to salt your meat before cooking it. Meat can be dense, tough, and low in moisture. It needs time for the salt to move through fatty membranes and provide flavor from the inside out. But Chopped contestants don't have hours, they have minutes. So if they are working with a large slab of sirloin or a whole chicken, they need to butcher the meat or poultry into smaller pieces in order for the salt to absorb faster. This isn't a skill restaurant or home cooks necessarily need to learn. It's often easier to prep meat well ahead of time, allowing the salt to really soak in. For this reason, Chopped contestants have a bad habit of under- or over-salting their food. It's not because they don't know how to season correctly, it's because in the limited time frame Chopped allows, the seasoning game is a whole different story. One of the reasons Chopped is as popular and beloved as it is may be that some of the contestants seem to have such intense, moving, and even tragic backstories. For instance, Chopped contestant Hip Lay was placed on a raft and sent out to sea by her mother as a refugee of the Vietnam War and went on to start a successful restaurant. Or Nang Pun Sukwatana, a Thai food truck owner who specialized in the simple dish of chicken and rice and managed to pull off a Chopped victory using her cooking skills. These stories are inspirational and make for great television, but you don't need a long and difficult backstory to make great food. You just need a grasp on good flavor and a place to cook. So while cooking can be a great way to work through past trauma or make a living without a traditional school education, it's also a great hobby for the rest of us who never end up competing on Chopped. Sure, on Chopped, cooking is a competition, and it's a cutthroat one at that. But cooking, as it turns out, is fun even when it's not a competitive sport. Cooking can be a great way to connect with friends, plan a fun date night, or as a stress relief on your own. Cooking is the perfect pair activity. This is because cooking gives you something to do and something to talk about so there are no awkward silences. It can also be a low-cost, low-maintenance date idea, way more economical than expensive concert tickets or a five-star restaurant. Plus, at the end of the activity, you get to share a meal together, and what's better than that?
We are super excited to welcome four couples to compete.
So open a bottle of wine, put on some nice music, and settle in for an evening of cooking. At least if the food doesn't turn out, you'll still have wine and music. Ted Allen, the host of Chopped, is one of the most recognizable faces on the Food Network. While he may be known for his quick wit, ruthless hosting, and excellent chopping block unveiling skills, Ted Allen is actually a pretty nice guy. He also has relatable sensibilities regarding food. For instance, Ted Allen reportedly loves cheese, sushi, and Indian flavors. According to a Food Network interview, he's a fan of simple ingredients, like vanilla and mustard, and he loves silly things, like the sound whole chicken in a can makes when it plops out of the can.
This is a mess.
This is disgusting.
Alan can keep up his stern and intimidating persona on Chopped all he wants, but at the end of the day, he seems like a generally down-to-earth guy with a love for food, gardening, and music. As it turns out, even the Chopped chefs have a little help when it comes to getting those meals churned out before Ted Allen announces that time is up. Apparently, simple kitchen prep tasks are already completed for the Chopped contestants, helping them get through their cooking projects more quickly. For example, Chopped contestants do not need to wait for their pot of water to boil. Production assistants on the show always get the water going before the clock starts. Additionally, Chopped contestants' ovens are already preheated to 350 degrees when the round begins. Waiting for an oven to preheat does not really test how well contestants can cook. Plus, a bunch of Chopped contestants sitting around playing on their phones and waiting for the ovens to preheat would not exactly make for great television. When the time comes for you to make something in your kitchen, you shouldn't assume that you can manage to get dinner on the table in 20 minutes. Oftentimes, just waiting for your oven or stovetop to be ready will take most of that time. A Chopped episode is only 40 minutes long, so you may think that the filming process is a relatively quick process. But filming these episodes actually takes way longer, sometimes up to 14 hours. Even though Chopped is a lightning-fast cooking competition show, production aspects including preparation, cooking, judging, cleaning, and resetting stations make shooting an episode a full-day affair, and an exhausting one at that. Even though the actual cooking is timed on a really tight schedule, judging can take way longer than television episodes depict, especially if two judges have a particularly heated disagreement over a dish. The magic of television is strong on Chopped. It may look like it takes no time at all to put everything together, but each episode takes a lot longer than it seems. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more mashed videos about your favorite cooking shows are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.